Good morning friends, today we will discuss about the solid state detectors, after that cloud chambers. First, solid state detectors. Solid state physics in BSc 5th semester we have done all the courses. Here it is based on the semiconductor radiation, semiconductor devices, a PN junction diodes. This detector is based on that. The field of nuclear physics has been completely revolutionized with the development of the semiconductor radiation detectors. So in 1949, K.G. Mackay, who was the first scientist that uses a PN junction maybe as a detector. A semiconductor radiation detector is a solid state version of gaseous ionization chamber. It is simply a reverse biased PN junction diode. In these diodes, ionizing radiation produces electron ion electron hole pairs in the depletion region. This process is just like creation of electron ion pairs in ionization chamber. So these pairs are collected by the electric field applied, and then the detector gives an electric pulse. The amplitude of this pulse is proportional to the energy of ionizing radiations. Since the semiconductor device, a detector, is a reverse biased, therefore the signal is much larger as compared to noise due to leakage current. Now, the K.G. Mackay, the scientist, he allotted a collimated beam of alpha particle to fall on a PN germanium junction and showed that nearly all of the energy of alpha particles absorbed by it or in it was utilized for the production of electron hole pairs. The important thing is here to discuss, to note that the average energy required to produce one electron hole pair is approximately, is about 3 electron volt, which is very very small as compared to the 35 electron volt energy required for the formation in gas for one ion pair. Now the constructions. It consists of a PN junction between P-type and N-type silicons. The N-type silicon layer is made to contact with a thin film of gold developed through the evaporation techniques. First, the question arises in everybody's mind that why we are taking the silicons in here, why we are not taking the germaniums. If in case of the germanium detectors, germanium have much better than those of the silicon because of large density of germaniums. So in case of the silicons, why we are taking the silicon? Because of its low intrinsic conductivity. This shows that the detector can be operated at room temperature without excessive leakage of current. So we want to reduce the leakage of current, that's why we are using the silicons. Okay, the reverse, it consists of a PN junction between P and N type silicon. The N type silicon layer is made in contact with a thin gold, this is the gold region, thin gold, thin film of gold developed through the evaporation technique. The reverse bias diode helps in minimizing the current flowing in the detector when no radiation is striking the detector. A positive reverse bias applied to the gold film, this gold film pushes all the positive charge carriers away from the junction and produces a depletion layer as shown in this figure. The depletion layer contains no positive or negative charge carriers. When an energetic charge particle moves through the depletion layer, its interaction with the electron in the crystal produces electron hole pairs. One electron hole pair is produced for every 3.5 electron volt in case of silicon energy lost by the charged particles. The electrons and holes are swept away by the applied electric field and are registered through a volt B over the resistor R. The number of charge carriers pairs produced in a semiconductor material is approximately 10 times as large as the number of ion pairs produced in a gas ion chamber. You can note it that in your notebook that 10 times as large as number of ion pairs produced in a gas ion chamber. The voltage pulse will be about 10 times large. Yeah, it means that the voltage pulse will be 10 times large. At this, the detector has better resolution of energy than the radiation detectors. So, the working of this, now we have a number of commonly used semiconductor detectors in detail in here. I just write down in the blackboards that diffuse junction detector is silicon surface variant detectors is there, ion implantation detector is there, silicon lithium detector is there, germanium lithium detector is there, high purity germanium detector is there. There are so many detectors in the solid state detector, but the basic principles and working we have discussed in the solid state detectors. Semiconductor detectors offer many advantages over scintillation or gas field detectors. Some of the advantages are here. Semiconductor detectors have excellent energy resolutions. It has linear response over a wide energy range of incident radiations. These detectors are gradually compact and smaller in size. These detectors are fast detectors. The one point is mentioned here that the mobility of electron is about 1500 centimeters per volt second, and mobility of hole is about 500 centimeter per volt second, which is much faster as compared to mobility of ions in case of the gas counters. These detectors can be fabricated in a wide range of sensitive depth and geometry. Initially, these detectors were developed for detection of heavy charge particles. Later on, with the advancement in the semiconductor technology, the detectors were developed for detection of electron, X-ray and gamma rays. So these are beyond the scope of our syllabus. You will discuss it in the higher study and the higher classes. Okay, now switch over to the next topic, that is the cloud chamber. Cloud chamber is also known as the Wilson's chamber, which was built by the Wilson in 1911. It is one of the detectors which provides visual trajectory of a charged particle. Charged particle such as electron, protons, alpha particle, etc. Now the principle of this detector, it is based on the principle that when dust-free air saturated with vapors of liquid means water, alcohol, ether, so many others, is allowed to expand adiabatically. Super saturation occur. Adiabatically means no heat is evolved, no heat is absorbed. If at this stage an ionizing particle enters the chamber and creates ion pairs, after that, the tiny droplet of liquid condenses on these ions and form a visible track along the path of the ionizing radiation. These visible tracks can be photographed. In some cases, The cloud chamber is subjected to a strong magnetic electric field. Such a field causes the charged particle to travel in a curved path. The curvature of the curved path gives information about the mass and charge of the ionizing particles. Now the constructions. A simplified form of the cloud chamber is shown in this figure. It consists of a transparent cylindrical chamber, CC chamber, with a piston P is fitted at the bottom. On the top of the cylindrical chamber is an optical flat glass plate G, and a camera is mounted on the top view inside the chamber. This chamber is illuminated with the light from a side with the help of a strong light source. Now the working of this chamber, of this detector, air saturated with given liquid is filled in the space between the movable piston P and glass plate G. The pressure inside the chamber is kept high. The pressure in the chamber is lowered by moving the piston up and down suddenly, due to which the temperature of the saturated liquid falls and vapor becomes supersaturated. If at this moment a charged particle pass through the chamber, it will produce ion pairs. The supersaturated vapor condense on the ions and a trail of droplet along the path of the charged particle is seen. यहाँ पे जो है आप droplets देख सकते हो. These tracks are known as cloud tracks. These tracks have distinguished shapes. In case of, for example, alpha particle, track is broad and straight, while an electron trajectory is thinner and show a zigzag trajectory. If the chamber is illuminated with the light, a camera can photograph of the track, which appears as white on a dark background. When vertical magnetic field is applied, positively and negatively charged particle curve in opposite directions. Now some of the advantages are listed here. With cloud chamber, the range of high energy particle can easily be determined. By seeing the broadness of the cloud track, we can immediately get an idea whether the track is due to heavy particles such as alpha particles or light particles like electrons. When applied the electric or magnetic field, cloud chamber is used to find charge on the ionizing particles and their momentums. Some of the limitations also of this detectors. If the energy of the ionizing particle is high, it may not completely stop in the cloud chamber and may come out of the chambers. So we will not get full information about the particles. This is the limitation of this. One more limitation is there. The recovery time of the cloud chamber is relatively very long, approximately 10 to 60 seconds after the expansion. So it may miss many ionizing particles during this period. Okay. Today we have discussed about the solid state detectors and cloud chambers. In the next lectures, we will be available bubble chambers, spark chambers, and last one is Cherenkov counters. In today's lecture, if any queries or any questions, you can ask me at contact me on my WhatsApp or emails. Thank you once again.